This is the first, the premiere, the numero uno episode of Our Two Cents. I am Sarah Mock, and I write How I Pinch a Penny. And today, my guest is Kathy Zucker of Metro Moms Network. Welcome, Kathy.
Thank you for having me, Sarah.
Thank you for being here. Can you tell my audience a little bit about how we know each other and where we met, if you want to say met?
Have we ever actually met in person? We haven't.
I don't think we've actually physically shaken hands type met.
I mean, I feel like we're best friends, but it's you and I met when we were recruited for a blogger panel by a company named Viewpoints. Mm-hmm. We're basically, as far as I can tell, our Carol Fowler, who was the vice president we were working with, went to blog her in New York City and recruited a whole bunch of bloggers.
Blogger 12 was my absolute first blogging conference ever.
Mine too. So what was very interesting about it was that all of the bloggers who wound up working on this panel, and I think there were about 10 of us.
Mm-hmm. I think that's about right.
You know, we have all kind of just taken off from there. You know, in the almost 3 years since then, I mean, if you look at the stuff that you and I have done, I mean, I look at you and you are everywhere. And meanwhile, I won an international award for social media. So basically I'm writing. And, you know, I have evolved from being a local parenting blogger to people tell me I have an international presence. I mean, I feel like it ebbs and flows, but certainly I had a lot of traffic from Germany of all places during the Shorty Awards last year. I mean, it brought down my site about 8 times.
Oh my goodness. Wow.
So, yeah, that was scary. But, Thank you. You know, it's just been an evolution. Like, am I a journalist? Am I, you know, a parent? Am I an entrepreneur? I'm kind of all of those things.
You're definitely all of the above, plus more, I'm sure.
Well, you know, but that is, I feel like, the beauty of blogging. You get to be whatever you want to be. I feel like we can use our blogs and social media to experiment with different, almost like different outfits. Like, we're actors on stage. And see what fits us best right at that moment in time.
And I really believe that authenticity comes across the loudest.
Oh, absolutely.
In whatever you're doing, whether it's video or writing or photography, as long as you're authentic, it just screams very loudly.
I used to be a marketing director in Manhattan, first in finance and then for a hospital. So when you are working for a corporation, they want you to do your job. And they want you to do your job very, very well. They don't want you to do anybody else's job. But it's basically like, this is it. These are your job responsibilities. You know, over time, usually it evolves because you'll get shifted to a different department or you'll add on responsibilities. But it's very, very, very clear cut. When you're working for yourself as a blogger, as an entrepreneur, it's like being on one of those game shows where they're just like throwing everything in the kitchen sink at you.
Yeah.
You never know what's going to happen.
And I mean, today, see what other bloggers are doing, like, oh, that looks like fun. Maybe I want to try that.
Yeah. And also you'll give each other, you know, we'll give each other the heads up where it's just like, hey,
you know, be aware. Like,
yeah. Like when you were on my last Google Plus hangout, I accidentally published
things happen.
And then it's like an uninvited guest who just came out of nowhere. I swear I don't know where that guy came from. It's like some days you are on the red carpet, you're on camera. Other days you are IT, bookkeeping. It's just,
it's every day. It's all the hats. You're wearing all of them. They're constantly switching. Sometimes you're having on 2, 3, 4 at the same time. And it's a juggling act. And sometimes you just got to take one of those balls and chuck it really high up in the air and hope it doesn't come down for a couple days because you need to be juggling with these over here.
Or, you know, as what's happening with me right now, you kind of just put all of your balls in a box and like a drawer and you shut the drawer and you say, okay, I need to take a step back and really think about all these balls that I have because I can't keep up with all of them. And the other thing about it too is that the market also changes. This is something that I have never yet met an entrepreneur who is prepared to handle. They think they are, they want to be, but what happens is your audience moves on. Either they find what they were looking for coming to you, or else they just move away, they leave. So, and you're looking at about a 3-year cycle.
Okay.
At the very most, you're getting at 5 years. So either you, so you have two choices at that point. Either you evolve with your audience or you bring in,
draw in
new people. It, right?
That's great that you said 3 years, because my blog is currently, I think we're at the 5-year mark, 5, maybe 6 years. And where it was year 1, 2, it is completely different animal than, yep, than what it was there. And I've evolved. I brought in, I don't want to say new audience, but a different audience. I've kept some, and they share, and social media is great for doing that on, for different platforms.
Absolutely.
We'll send out different messages to different demographics.
What's interesting is that I am going more and more and more towards social media. Like, the blog is almost, I don't want to call it an afterthought, but it's like my home base, my platform, right? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, explain to my audience what the Metro Moms Network is, where your location is, what your purpose is, and how that has transpired over the past couple of years, and how that has really been like your entrepreneurial, can I call it your baby?
Yes, it is definitely my baby, but it's not my first entrepreneurial venture. It's okay. Actually my third. Oh, okay.
So if I were to Google Metro Moms Network, I would land at
MetroMoms.net.
MetroMoms.net.
Basically, at its core, it's a magazine.
Okay.
So the whole concept is that there are businesses. What we want to do is help parents get back to work and also take their careers to different places. Because I meet so many parents who are frustrated, either because they are not happy with the job. Like, the job they had before they became parents is not working for their lives after they become parents. Mm-hmm. So we want to help people transition to something new and ideally better, or become an entrepreneur.
Excellent.
Because, I mean, look at, you know, you and I are both entrepreneurs. We're sitting here on our computers conducting an interview with little kids in the next room.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, it is very, 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 very hard to maintain a career and deal with childcare.
It is. And that's partly why I got into blogging, was I would be able to have this blog, a business, and be a stay-at-home mom at the same time. Little did I know, it was now a 16-hour job doing the two at the same time.
Yeah, it never ends. I mean, yeah. I'm up at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah. I mean, being a mom is a 24/7 job, and then you throw another 16 hours on top of that and do the math, and it's tough.
I mean, this is one of my biggest challenges, managing my workload. And my husband's commute is super short, so he can basically take a second shift and back me up. Like, last night, he came home at 8 o'clock. I went to bed. He comes in the door. I hand the kids off to him. I go right to bed. Hello. 3 o'clock, I get up and I'm working. I'm writing. I am sending out emails. You know, this is how we make it work. Mm-hmm. But also, people know where to find me. They know I'm in Hoboken. And also opportunities, because look, we all know this. New York City is the place to be.
It is. At least on the East Coast. That's just,
oh yeah,
it's the hub.
That's where you have, it's a media, it's where everything happens. And just the fact that we are, like, I kind of feel like I had the best of both worlds, because we are technically New Jersey, but so, you know, we kind of like check that other box, but at the same time, we are so close to Manhattan that, I mean, I'm in there probably 3 times a week. Mm-hmm. Like, this summer, I have zero scheduled as far as camps go, because I'll just make it up as I go along.
Yeah. And that, you know, that's like, the beauty of being an entrepreneur and being a blogger. You don't have to be set in a set schedule. You can set your own schedule, or you can just block it out and say, hey, these 2 weeks we're doing nothing. We're going to roll with the punches. If something comes up, we're going to go. That's what I love about it.
What I've found over the 4 years since I founded this company is that it takes much, 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 much longer to become profitable and to have a really solid business model. And it's much more expensive. Like, whatever you think your time and your costs are going to be, triple them.
Yeah.
and that's much more likely to be what you wind up spending. So,
and I was also going to say that it seems like people are overnight sensations. Like they were nobody 2 weeks ago, but all of a sudden they're at the top of the Twitter list. They are on Instagram. They're fabulous. Don't see the backside of all the preparations and the steps that it took to get there. It truly was not overnight.
No, there is no such thing as an overnight success. Typically, I mean, I've read statistics. If you read consistently every single day, and reading is crucial to being a successful entrepreneur, you cannot be successful in a silo. You have to know what is going on in your industry, what changes are coming, what's working for other people. You have to consume an enormous amount of information just to find that those tiny kernels here and there, they're going to be relevant to your situation.
Mm-hmm. And then you have to apply it to you and your brand.
Correct.
I can't be talking about sports because I can't run. It just isn't happening. It's not pretty. But I could be talking about canning and gardening and crafting and cooking and what's going on in those worlds and then apply it to the frugal side of how I pinch a penny.
Right. And the other flip side of that also is it has to be something that your audience wants to hear. Like, for example, a great example. You know what my true core strength is, my expertise? Healthcare. Bet you didn't know that.
Healthcare. Oh. Look at you collecting puke all over the place. Putting that healthcare to work.
Healthcare, the RN that every single mom really kind of qualifies for. We should get credits for the nursing degree.
Oh, we should.
Yeah, I used to write the annual report for my hospital. I was the representative for my hospital, Cabrini Medical Center, at Greater New York Hospital Association. So about a year, my husband comes to me and says, why don't you write about healthcare? Because you've got the chops for it. You want to know why? Because I lose followers every time I write about it.
Yeah, you got to know your audience and what they like and what they respond to.
Yeah, what happens is I like to talk to people. The same way I talk to you, I talk to Dana. I talk to basically everybody I cross paths with, which drives my husband crazy. Because
your husband and my husband need to get together and compare notes because I'm like, blah, 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 blah. He's like, can you just not talk to everybody all the time, everywhere we go? I'm like, but he's like, just bring it in. Just no.
For once.
Just once.
Go and come back quickly. Right? Like my husband's scared to have you go with the mail because he knows it could turn into a 2-hour trip.
Yes.
Being an entrepreneur and having a partner, it makes things a lot more complicated, but at the same time, it also can be a really great benefit.
Yes.
Because I am home, my husband has been able to take on work assignments that are last minute and that are much longer hours than most people can do. And as a result, his career has really taken off. I mean, you got to figure that he as an individual is now earning what the two of us were earning combined back when we were dual income, before we had kids.
That's awesome.
And, and that's because he's been able to step up and really hit the ball out of the park when he's had these opportunities.
So you guys really, truly partner together and are the yin and the yang, so to speak, of the Zucker family household. Of supporting each other and enabling each other to be your best.
That's correct. I mean, look, we will do a check usually 12 months out. So I want to say it's around this time of year because the school year starts in September. So for us, it's like the fiscal year for a lot of companies, it's January. For us, it's more like July to June, right? And we're talking to each other throughout the year also. So we get a sense of what's going on with the other person, but we'll have these come to Jesus talks over the summer where it's, all right, what's going on? I have to change jobs. I'm stagnating here. I have to start pushing. Like we used to do this thing before we had kids where we would trade off cooking. And there was never a conscious decision of this year I cook, next year you cook. It was just kind of one of us would be more busy one year than the other one. And so we would kind of naturally just start going in that direction. And then next thing you know, I look back and it's been 12 months that I've been doing the cooking. And then all of a sudden my life gets crazy. I look back, it's been 12 months that he's been cooking. Like I still talk about his lemon chicken. He thinks I'm crazy because it's been like 10 years since he's made lemon chicken, but I still remember how good it was. He's a good cook. So what I'm saying here is that there is an ebb and flow in every relationship. And when you're an entrepreneur, it's more so. I'm a judge this year in the short year where I'll be returning next year as a judge. And I became a Dove model after, winning the Shorty Awards. I was interviewed recently by AOL Finance, and they detailed my history as an entrepreneur because I used to be the marketing director for a beverage company. That's actually what I was doing right before starting the Metro Moms Network. I was approached by one of my marketing clients who said, "You are amazing at marketing. Come on and do our marketing." I said, "You realize I know nothing about beverages, right?" And he's like, "Doesn't matter. Marketing's marketing." I was like, "Okay." And it was incredible. I wound up getting an education in beverages and startups. And I'm bringing my four-year-old son along with me with a DVD player. He's sitting there in the laboratory and he's like, dying to get into the beaker. So I'm like, sweetie, don't break anything. This is just kind of par for the course. You go with mom to, the multi-million dollar facility and you taste some beverages. My kids are a part of every aspect of my business. And I mean, every single one. They help me stuff goodie bags for expos. They will come. They want to staff the tables, like, the front desk at, events. And, I've brought my son to laboratories to sample beverages, we're making all natural products at a bottling plant. My kids go everywhere with a couple of exceptions, but 90% of the time, whatever I do, I can include my kids in. And there's a reason why I have structured my business life like this, because first and foremost, I'm a mom.
Yes.
My responsibilities as a mom and as a wife trump everything else. But the same can also be said for my husband. So, we met in college on our fencing team. So we're both very competitive with each other too, which is interesting for people because they're like, "You guys have swords." Yes, that's kind of scary.
Oh, but it's fun. Like,
it's like, hey, everything's fine until somebody gets, stabbed. But
flesh wound.
Yeah, nobody's ever been hospitalized. It's good. So, let's put it this way.
It's all perspective.
Yeah. Everything, life is a journey. And we are here for self-actualization. So, for example, my husband took a new job almost exactly a year ago. So last August, he started with a technology company in Manhattan. And he took a really big pay cut for this job. And he did it with my blessing because I knew this was coming. He had been talking to me about it for a couple of years beforehand. And I kept saying, wait, I'm pregnant, need benefits, wait.
Yes, very important.
And basically when the baby was a year old, I said to him, go with my blessing. We are stable now. We're done having kids, I think. And, we can make this work. So we took the kids out of private school. They're in public school and they're doing great. And, I have been changing my company. My husband and I have a deal. Whatever I earn through my entrepreneurial ventures, I can reinvest back into my companies. So I started the Metro Moms Network in 2010 with the proceeds from the sale of my stake in the beverage company where I was a marketing director.
Okay.
And, it's been very, very, very different from what I expected. I thought that basically we were going to be like Mommy Poppins, right? I know some of the top people at Mommy Poppins. I figured, okay, we'll do something similar, only for New Jersey. And what I found out is that that business model does not work in the Hoboken area.
And once again, it's knowing your client and your audience. And if it doesn't work, don't do it.
That's correct. But what's very interesting is that I am getting a ton of attention every time I write about business. Because it's very rare to have a young parent. Not that I'm so young, but my kids are very young. It's very rare to have someone who is entrepreneurial and minded, plus has a marketing background and also is in social media. I mean, the confluence of those three things are unusual, and it just has gotten me a lot of attention, which is what basically led to this following. I wound up attracting all those people because the number one question everybody asks me is, how do you manage? What's your time like? Mm-hmm. And then, I tell them, I wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning and I work for 3 hours till it's time for the kids to get up. Then I get them off to school. Then I keep working. Then it's time for school pickup. And I don't watch TV, pretty much at all. I have a TiVo. I'll record shows. But it's very, very, very rare that you're going to find me in front of a live show that's happening. I mean, I watch TV maybe once a month.
Yeah, we do a lot of binge watching, a lot of Netflix type thing. And I'll
Yeah.
have it on, but I'm not sitting watching it. I'm doing three things while it's
Exactly.
happening.
Yeah. So like the people who are passionate about that, who are like they're sitting there and they're engaging and they're tweeting and saying like, "Oh my God, did you see what just happened?"
Yeah.
That just really doesn't happen for me. 9 times out of 10, I'm doing work stuff because this is what I love.
Yeah,
This is what I want to do.
yep. Tell me about being the entrepreneurial parent. How has your parenting changed from when your first daughter was born to now you've got three kids and your entrepreneurial juices are just have shot up. They kept keep going.
They're on overload now.
Yeah, so boo.
I am a lot more relaxed. Or it's not so much that I'm more relaxed as I am. Like, look, nobody's died, right?
Bonus.
That's my goal for each day. Well,
Yeah.
everyone's alive. Nobody's poisoned, I think.
That we can see.
I mean, like, okay, a great example, diaper bags, right? With my first kid, I had a Pottery Barn Kids gorgeous cranberry quilted diaper bag. I would not leave the house unless that was fully stocked with diapers, wipes,
Two
bottles of
outfits.
water,
Yeah.
nipple shield in case I wanted to breastfeed, formula. Like that was before the formula singles existed. So you'd had like, there was like containers that looked like a clock where you'd have like different compartments,
Yeah.
and I'm making sure it's fresh formula and all this stuff. It would take me an hour to get ready to the house. Probably more like two. Now, I don't bring a stroller half the time.
Yeah.
I have a little umbrella stroller I leave in the car. If we happen to need it when we're out, great. But most of the time, either
It's
I
gone.
carry this kid or she walks, and I have a little bottle of water in my handbag, like one of those like disposable ones. So I know whenever we use it up, just go grab another one from the stash and one diaper. That's it.
That's all you need. It's amazing how we can go from one to three kids, how we change our parenting styles and our parenting skills.
I also think that this has really, really, really helped shape my kids into worker bees. I mean, they were over at my parents' house last weekend, and my parents were shocked because they come to me and they're like, "We had the kids out in the backyard, and grandma starts weeding, and the kids just jump right in, start helping.
We'll help.
Don't even hesitate, you know?"
Yeah. Tell us a little bit about what you have coming up in the future. You were telling me you have a project you're working on.
Yes, I'll have a couple of major things going. One I can't really talk about yet because it's a really, really, really big deal. Basically, I met with a group of 10 bloggers. So I was one, so that's nine actually. But there were 10 of us who were invited down there to talk about potentially really big things happening there.
That's exciting.
Incredible. It's exact. Can I just, this is why I'm an entrepreneur, because things that I've been waiting for just happened. I had been looking for a venue for the Metronome Expo. I've gone as far as I can here. Where do I take it? I need a place that has resources and no, and that's just what landed in my lap. And I couldn't believe it. I had no idea what it was going to be either. I just thought I was getting invited for a blogging event. I mean, like, you and I get invited every 10 minutes. It's like, oh,
Yay,
blogging
social
event. Oh.
networking.
Yeah, it's just, this is what I mean about hanging out in one place. If you keep doing something for long enough, even if it feels like you're banging your head against the wall, and you are clear in your message and consistent, sooner or later, everything falls into place.
Yes.
And it's like nothing, 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 nothing for the first 90%, and then all of a sudden it just takes
Just
off.
like boom, 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 boom. Yeah.
Yeah, and like hang on, or hang on, just hang on to
Yeah,
your
like
hat.
just wait a minute. Just give me I will
Yes.
breathe in 5 days after I get through all of this, then we'll regroup and we'll do it again.
Right. I mean, 50% of any effort that you do as an entrepreneur is preparation. And then the other 50% is being in the right place in the right time.
Yes.
But you have to be ready for that moment when things just happen.
Yeah.
So the other thing that I am doing that is kind of like my preparation for the next stage, because my youngest child will go into preschool in 15 months because we have free full-time preschool here in Hoboken. So I am kind of getting ready for that next stage of my life when the kids are in school. And I'm writing a book.
Excellent.
Yeah, and it's about how to form your own network. Because can I tell you, this network, these ladies, the six ladies on my team, plus the other, the 2,000 who are in the network, there's like 30,000 who read my blog. They have just kept me going for the last 4 years now. And there were, you know, I mean, you saw during the Shorty Awards, they just came out of nowhere. Not that many parents are on social media, specifically Twitter. And just all these people just came out of nowhere and they're tweeting stuff like, I could not have survived Hurricane Sandy without Kathy. Mm-hmm. And that was all because of the network, because I had been putting in the time to meet people and help them and just get to know them. So when I put out the call saying, hey, guys, floodwater's coming, move your cars, people listened. Yeah. And I set up a text messaging group to communicate with people during the hurricane. And, you know, because nobody knew we were going to be out of power or surrounded by floodwaters for that long. So I feel like the next logical stage is to write about how I was able to create this strong community of trust. Mm-hmm. Such that, you know, when something like that happens, like nobody knew the Hurricane Sandy was going to be anywhere near that bad.
Yeah.
And, you know, I mean, frankly, I would have evacuated if I had known.
Yeah.
But, you know, it just happened so fast. I mean, I had like 6 hours warning. That's literally the lead time I had and everybody else. It gave me enough time to move my car, secure my household, lock down, but I wasn't prepared to evacuate. How can people create their own network? Because anybody can do what I did. All you have to do is talk to people and get to know them and find like-minded people who are looking to build skills, because that's ultimately what this is all about. The best way you can be prepared to go into a new job is to just start doing it.
Yeah.
You know, show up today, start experimenting, talk to people who are in the industry, lurk on Twitter. That's a huge one. I love Twitter so much. Because I can talk to people at all levels of organizations. And plus, I can see what they're doing in their work lives. You know, so that's one of the amazing miracles of blogging. It opens all sorts of doors for you that you never, ever, ever would have gotten. Like, you know, I figure I've given up probably about $2 million in income by staying home. Like, if I had gone back to work full time when my oldest child was 12 weeks old, you know, the way I thought I would, I would have earned a lot more money than I have. But I mean, I basically, for all intents and purposes, been home my entire 30s. But you know what? The way I look at it is that I would be qualified to be a vice president in healthcare right now. And hospitals are all consolidating. There are fewer jobs at that level now. So I could either be vice president level in a dying industry, or I could be vice president level, which is basically what I am, in social media marketing, which is, you know, it's exploding, it's taking off.
It's huge.
And so
we're in it.
Yeah, exactly. I have not given up anything in terms of career development. And in fact, I have developed credentials in a whole different field that basically puts me at the same level where I was when I left, you know, the corporate world. And on top of that, you know, this is what I love. Like, I've really had a chance to experiment with a whole bunch of different roles, because when you are an entrepreneur, you have to be able to do everything.
Yes.
You know, there's no such thing as, you know, I'll just hire somebody to do my graphics, my marketing. You don't have the money to do that. Mm-mm. So you have to either barter with somebody who does have that expertise, mm-hmm. or
learn.
You figure out how to do it. Yeah, there are amazing tools out there. Like, there's a stock photo site that I use. Oh, Deposit Photos. Okay.
Okay. Deposit Photos.
DepositPhotos.com is insane. Lucy Bata, who used to be the publisher of NJ Family Magazine, turned me on to it. And this is the other thing, too. I am basically connected on social media with all these people who have expertise in areas that I don't have. So we can, you know, cross disseminate. It's like we're sharing information with each other. So she turns me on to Deposit Photos. It costs me 10 cents each to download huge, high resolution, incredible stock images.
And what about the copyrights and rights, the copyrights on those? It's included?
Have them. It's included.
Awesome.
And you know, it's like you go to like a lot of the stock photo sites and there's like a different price for the different resolution levels. This, you get the highest possible resolution. I'm getting files that are like 4 to 8 megabytes in size for 10 cents.
Awesome.
I told you about the book. Basically, my book is going to be a part how to build your own network, but also a memoir. So I'm going to be using my personal experiences in creating my network that basically helped me survive a national disaster. Right?
Yeah.
You know, I mean, how to create your own network using examples from my life.
This has been Kathy Zucker of Metro Moms Network, and I'm Sarah Mock, and this is the premiere episode of Our Two Cents. Kathy, thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
And tell us all once again where we can find you. Tell us all your social media channels, because I'm sure everybody's going to want to follow you.
Okay, well, it's simple because everything is at Kathy Zucker. So same, and my last name. So Thyzucker. I am on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, Google Plus, I think, yes, I am at Kathy Zucker Plus, LinkedIn.
Okay, I will have all those links in a blog post and in the comment section below. You guys can click on over and see those. Thank you, Kathy. I so appreciate your time.